Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Prestige, and today we're going to be playing Blackout. In this video, I want to talk about how to unlock the specialist characters in this mode. For those of you that are unaware, the specialist characters are currently locked, but you have to do in-game challenges in order to unlock them. Some of these challenges are pretty easy, while others may be a little difficult for the average player. Either way, as of creating this video on October 14th, not all specialist characters are available, but we are going to be talking about the ones that are available. Once we learn more about the other specialist characters, I'll make sure to make a part 2 or an update video to this one, letting you guys know how to do those challenges. As of right now, Prophet, Seraph, Ruin, and Nomad are not currently available, but all other specialists are. So let's start off with, by far, the easiest character that you can unlock, and this is the one that a majority of people are going to get for their first unlock, Ajax. You can unlock Ajax in Blackout by killing enemies that are wearing armor. If you destroy the enemy's armor and then go to their death stash, you'll find that they have something called broken armor plating. Just pick it up and put it in your inventory, and you're going to have a total of 3 of these things. So you're gonna have to do this 3 total times, unless you go to enemy death statches and enemies didn't actually pick up their broken armor plating. But once you have 3 of these in your inventory, all you got to do is complete the game. You don't have to come in first, second, or third. You can die immediately after you have 3, and you should unlock Ajax. The next easiest character to unlock is Battery. Battery has a specialist weapon called the War Machine, and what you're going to have to do is find a supply drop that comes out of the sky, hope that it has the War Machine, and what you have to do is eliminate at least 1 enemy player with the War Machine and finish within the top 15. And I'm going to tell you guys right now, these supply drops that come in are so randomized that it's most likely not even going to contain a War Machine. You're just going to have to basically go after every single supply drop you see and hope that you find it. The next few unlocks is actually pretty dang difficult, depending on, you know, RNG and the luck that you get when a supply drop comes into the sky. So let's talk about Torque. You're also going to need to find an item out of a supply drop called a Note from Torque. This is going to probably be a little piece of paper, and all you gotta do is pick that up and put it in your inventory. That's where you would think this would end, but in order to unlock the character, you're gonna have to find razor wire and barricade. So you have to deploy at least 2 razor wires and use at least 1 barricade throughout your game of Blackout, and finish within the top 7. If you do not do this, then you will not get Torque. Like I said, it's completely RNG. This is probably going to be one of those things you're going to want to play with the team as. You know, if people find barricades or people find those razor wires, just ask for them, drop them down, be done with it. And then it's all about finding the note from Torque. If that is not in the supply drop, then you're going to have a bad time. The next character in this list is Recon. Recon's a little bit easier than Torque, but still difficult all the same if you're not that good at Blackout. This character is going to also be based off of RNG and the supply drops. If you find something called Ching coins inside the supply drops, you're going to want to pick those up, hold on to those in your inventory, and then what you need to do is not take any specific damage from the circle. Do not take any damage at all, and finish in the top 7, and you'll unlock Recon. I've seen a few people running around with Recon. We've opened tons of supply drops, and we personally have not been able to find these coins yet. Like I said, it's complete RNG and randomness. The next character you'll unlock is Firebreak, and you can get him by finding the burned doll item in the supply drops that drop from the plane above the Blackout map. You have to kill at least 1 enemy with some sort of fire damage. It doesn't matter if it's a Molotov or with the purifier itself, you just have to kill an enemy with fire damage and then complete the game. You don't have to come in top 10, top 15, or anything like that. Just have the burned doll item on you, kill an enemy with fire damage, and be done with it. And that's a lot harder than it sounds. You know, people avoid Molotovs pretty easily. You're gonna have to find someone who's not paying attention and hope that they die by the fire damage and get completely killed, not just knocked. So that's something to keep in mind. And then finally, the last character that we can unlock currently is Crash. And I think that this one is actually the most difficult out of all of them, specifically because of what it's asking you to do. So in order to unlock Crash, you're going to have to find the poker chips item. As of right now, what we know is you can find these poker chip items in the medical kit, which would be like the bag you find that has a trauma kit kits and med kits and bandages all in one. I don't really know how rare these are. I've been trying to find it myself, but I haven't been lucky lately. And then what you need to do is have at least 15 healing items in your inventory. That's med packs, bandages, trauma kits. You have to have at least 15 of those. More than 15 is recommended, and you have to finish the game within the top 3. This is probably the hardest character that you're going to have to unlock right now in Blackout. This is one that I don't know if I'm ever going to do, specifically because I don't really care for these specialist skins. I'm more worried about what skins come in the future, and I'm really happy with my Shadow Man skin that I currently have in the Blackout mode, but overall, that's how you unlock Crash, that's how you unlock all the other characters, and once we learn more, I'll make sure to make an update video for you guys, but I know that these challenges are not the simplest for many out there. And on top of that, I think Treyarch has already been talking about potentially changing these challenges or making them a little more lenient for people who may not be that good. I mean, we're talking about the main 10 specialists that are in this game. I feel like they should be available no matter what, just because, you know, they're on the game, so maybe the challenge would be a little bit easier. Maybe don't have a rank requirement, you know, finishing in the top 3 and stuff. Some of them I can agree with. Others just don't really make any sense. I'm more interested in seeing what skins they add in the future. Not too much with what's in the game right now, because like I said, I'm happy with the Shadow Man. Anyway, guys, let me know what y'all think down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video here today, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day if you're new to the channel. And guys, don't forget to join the notification squad by clicking that little bell icon next to the subscribe button. Let YouTube notify you when my videos go live, and I'll catch you all on the next one. Peace.